Buenas tardes, good afternoon. Welcome to Community at Works. Just remember, we are live. If you have any questions throughout all the half an hour, you could call us 610-378-0426. My name is Josie, and I work at Community Prevention Partnership. And I'm here to talk about KAP, Kids Against Pressure. And we have our two guests. They're going to introduce themselves later on. But KAP, it's an after-school program that we are funded through our SAM, and we are very fortunate to work with Reading School District. And right now we have 5 elementary schools. The girls are in 16th and Hawk, but we have 12 in Marion, we have Tyson Shaner, we have Amanda Stout, and 13th in Union. This program is tailored to Latino students, but we do have other ethnicity in our program, and we work with 3rd, 4th, and 5th graders. How this work is the teachers make referrals, or we do recruitment throughout in the school. We work with the principals, and we work with the guidance counselors. We do have 16 slots. So this year we're pretty done. We're gonna be done in May, but our recruiting part of the program is on October, right after the school begins. Para las personas que nos están escuchando de habla hispana, esto es un programa después de la escuela, y este programa está en 5 escuelas este año. Gracias a Dios tenemos 16 and Hawk, tenemos 12 Marion, Amanda Stout, tenemos Tyson Shaner, y tenemos 13 Union. Este programa se le habla acerca de prevención, de diferentes temas, y temas que están sucediendo en la comunidad, por ejemplo, intimidación, resolución de conflictos, autoestima, y esa es la parte que nosotros hacemos, enseñarle a estos niños de la vida cotidiana que está pasando, que está sucediendo afuera y adentro de la escuela. We do talk about prevention, we talk about self-esteem, we talk about conflict resolution, we talk about bullying, which is a biggie outside and inside the school, and we are incorporating nutrition this part. This is some of the stuff that we do. Then, I'm going to go through my guests today. They're going to say their name. They're going to say, I don't know, whatever they want to say. They could say the age, what school you're from, and then we go from there. Okay? So first we have?
Maria.
Maria. And
I go to school at 16th and Hawk, and I'm 10 years old.
You're 10 years old? Mm-hmm. Okay, and then who else we have?
Yvonne, I'm 10 years old. I go to 16th and Hawk.
Okay, Yvonne was in KAP last year, during the whole year, right? Excuse me. And then you went to the summer camp. How about if you tell people that you tell them how was it? What is it that you do in KAP, first of all, in the KAP program? What is it that we talk about, and what is it that you do?
We learn about bullying, people, and...
Bullying, we talk about drug prevention.
Drug prevention, and we shouldn't do drugs, and what... how to take care of our bodies.
Mm-hmm. How about for the summer camp? Remember the summer camp?
Well, we go on trips with everybody.
Mm-hmm.
It's fun at summer camp.
How about Maria? How's been? You just been in KAP for maybe 2 months?
Yeah, 2 months.
2 months? How you like it?
I like it really much because you learn about bullying, and it's fun because you don't need to worry about how people bully you because they won't allow it, and if they don't follow the rules, they'll get kicked out of the KAP.
Okay. What is it, one of the incentives that we give in the summer, in the program? What's the big incentive that we give you for attendance, to participate?
Oh, okay.
Excuse me.
Okay. We give KAP dollars.
KAP dollars are fake money. So they get KAP money for
behaving,
participate. If they help, like Yvonne, she's always helping, and she always wants to get involved on everything that we're doing. So then at the end of the program, they have two KAP stores. They have one in December before Christmas, and then at the end of the program, which is ending May 23rd, the third week of May, they get another KAP store. So they have this mobile store coming into them so they could spend their money on the store. So this is your first experience buying from the KAP store. How about you, Yvonne? Do you find it fun?
I do find it fun.
Do you recommend the kids to, if they're locally, we'll see if we have the same schools this year, but we are targeting other schools to be able to have either different schools plus different students. Because we do get a lot of repeaters. They love the program so much that they want to come back. But this year, they are one more year they have in the school. So if we have it in 16th and Hawk, they're going to sign up again. Right? Okay. So you were talking about the KAP store. How's the KAP store?
Well, we take turns so we don't fight about it. And
it's always as a teamwork, right? Yeah. What else? Do you have right now a lot of KAP dollars?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You do?
I have 16 of them.
You have 16?
Yeah.
That's a lot. Do you guys want to say something else? Do you recommend the kids to come?
Yes.
For next year?
Yes.
It is this year when the school starts again in August. So what would you say to these kids that are in these schools to sign up?
Because they can learn about that it's not right to be bullied, and it's not fair to other people to get bullied and they didn't even do anything to you.
Okay. Good. So you could learn
about
how to control that bully and how to deal with bullies, and when you're bullied, you know how to deal with them. That's exactly what we do in the program. We teach them how to deal with the bullies in a positive way. We also talk about peer pressure and how to deal with that peer pressure inside and outside the school. And we also do personal hygiene and oral hygiene. This year we incorporate those two lesson plans. I think I'm gonna go to the PowerPoint presentation now. We're gonna show some pictures. Girls, I think you're not in these pictures, but we're gonna go along. The other stuff we do in the KAP program, they eat a snack, we go to the lesson plan, and every time we have a craft or an activity to do with the kids, and this time we did Halloween craft where they decorate cookies. This is Tyson. I'm gonna have some pictures. Here they're working together. We did the frosting, we made it ourselves, and we bought the coloring food. And it's nice to see how they work together as a team this is his final project. He did he put everything in the cookies and then they ate it. So this is another one. How cute. Look at their. The kids are very creative. I mean, you tell them what to do, and then they do whatever they want. This is another one. Everything is going to be on that Halloween craft because it was, they loved to get messy. The cookies were pre-made. They were baked at home. It was Lindsay, that girl that did you see there? We get a lot of interns to work with us because they are in the social worker field. And since we work with kids from third to fifth grade, we get a lot of internships, and then they work with the kids. She had to do a project on making a lesson plan, and they loved it. They did love her. It's another one, working together. This is 13th and Union Elementary School. This is another craft that they made. It was on February for Valentine's Day. So we took a picture and we put it into a phone. And that's his cookies. He put everything again. Look, we had marshmallows, we had gummy bears. This is my favorite student. I shouldn't say that. Nathan, he's always posing, and he's a great student. Again, just decorating. This is an honor roll student, Anna Aguado. This is Isaiah. He is funny, right? Anna Marie. Then they just eat them. Para las personas que nos están viendo y solamente hablan español, estamos pasando unas fotos de algunas de las manualidades que se hacen en el programa. Este día era para el Día de las Brujas o el Día de Halloween, como se le dice en español. Ellos estaban haciendo unas galletitas y las estaban decorando con mermelada, con todo lo que había. Okay, this is Inabel Reese. She works with Women in Crisis and the Hispanic Center. And she has a workshop about, you guys remember this one? Or you guys weren't there? She was doing Pete the Peacemaker. In Spanish, it's Pedrito the Peacemaker, I guess. And they were talking about how to become a peacemaker in this community in Reading. So the kids had learned a lot, and they built Pedrito, as you see in your right. It's like a muñeco. We are going on a break right now, and we'll be right back.
BCTV has helped me to give a voice to the animal issues that are near and dear to my heart.
It means community. It means bringing information to you and your family to make informed decisions about your community, your life.
It is an outlet for all your community happenings, from sports to art, to anything that you want to find out that's going on in the county.
Remember, BCTV. Be informed, be involved.
I have an announcement from BCTV. You could become a member of BCTV. We need 75 new members by June 30th. Oh. And you could go into www.bctv.org. And you can sign up. We are live, so if you guys have a question, you have a question for the girls, for Maria or Yvonne, or for myself, Josie, Phone number is 610-378-0426. We're going to go back to the PowerPoint presentation. And we were talking about Pedrito the Peacemaker. Inabel went to all the schools, all five schools that we are doing the program. And they built Pedrito. The kids had a lot of fun. They learned. This is 16th and Honk, but you guys are not here. Again, they're making cookies. Right now, we have pretty big group in 16th and Honk. We recruited on, I think it was April. We have almost 36 kids in 16th and Honk. We do divide them into three, but it's challenging, right? Right, girls? This is Amanda Stout. Again, they're decorating
cookies.
The cookies. Here you have Eduardo, Alba, and Jamelis with those big cookies full of sugar. And that's it. And I think the girls wanted to say something about the program. You girls want to say something about the program? Come on. Okay.
I hope my mom's watching.
The summer camp. Huh? The summer camp. Let's talk about the summer camp. This year we are, again, we're very fortunate to have the summer camp this year. We're going to be having the summer camp from June 20th to July 2nd at Holy Cross. And we are recruiting kids for this summer camp, but if your child has to be in one of our five schools, either Amanda Stout, 13th and Union, 12th and Marion, Tyson Shaner, 16th and Honk, to be part of this summer camp. Our phone number is 610-376-6988. You could contact me, or if you're seeing the show, you have a question, you could contact us. We do it's a two-week summer camp. It's from 8 o'clock in the morning to 4 p.m. This year, the kids are gonna make their own food. So it's going to be fun. We're going to be in the kitchen a lot. We're going to be learning. We're going to be teaching them this nutrition part of making, you know, making good decision when you go and buy stuff in the supermarket, or how to choose the right food instead of just going to get pizza every time or stuff like that. So it's going to be very, very interesting, this summer camp coming up. Again, you can contact us, 610-376-6988. A little bit more about my program, if you just turn on the TV. This is an after-school program for Latino students, but we do have other students coming in and signing in. We do work with referrals, and we work with recruitment. We are looking to go to another schools and have new students coming in. But this year, we are going to end the program by the third week of May. So, para la gente que nos habla, que habla español, estamos hablando del programa de KAP. Jóvenes contra la presión se diría en español. Es un lugar positivo para después de la escuela. El programa comienza después de la escuela de 3 y 10 a 4 y media. Los niños aprenden a desarrollar destrezas positivas en este programa. Se le enseña acerca de la prevención de drogas y alcohol. Se le enseña de presión de grupo, intimidación en la escuela y fuera de la escuela. Y también se le enseña acerca de la resolución de conflicto y cómo bregar con su autoestima. También añadimos una porción de nutrición y de higiene personal y ejercicio en el currículo, que no lo teníamos antes. Si su niño está entre las escuelas de 16 y Marion, 12 y Marion, 16 y Hawk, Amanda Stout, Tyson Shaner, and 13 Union, I think I said them all. 16th and Hawk. They could sign up. Okay? Okay, girls, you have to say something. Tell these kids how great is this is the program, or how bad is the program. I don't know. Come on.
Let me see.
How say something positive about the program. What else they wanna hear what else we do in the program.
We do arts and crafts.
Arts and crafts. What kind of arts and craft? Well, we just showed the Halloween craft. What else we did? We did the Mother's Day. You guys did a card?
Yes, we did.
For your mom?
She loved it.
She loved it? What else? Yvonne?
We did Valentine's.
6 minutes.
Valentine's?
5 minutes.
Okay. This 2 weeks that are left on the program, we're going to be talking about drug prevention, okay? Mm-hmm. So we have Brandon Stouts. He's the Army guy. Remember the Army guy from last year? What was it that he did, Yvonne? You remember?
He showed us how drunk people act.
How drunk people are?
I don't know what drunk people are. With goggles.
Okay. They put some goggles on, and they have the effect that a drunk driver, I guess, is. So they put the goggles on, and they were trying to walk into a straight line. They couldn't do it. They were trying to sit down. They couldn't do it because they had the goggles, and it had those cool effect. Not cool, but, you know. What else they were making? They were trying to grab pieces of, what's it, paper clips and put it inside a vase, and they couldn't do it.
Sometimes people can't even drive because they're drunk.
Exactly, you can't be driving and drinking and driving. What else he did? Remember, Yvonne? He talked about. You don't remember? He talked about drug prevention.
Like you shouldn't do drugs.
Mm-hmm. We have 3 more minutes. Again, if you have any question about this program, we've been around for almost 10 years with Kids Against Pressure. We've been in other schools. This year we are working in those 5 that I mentioned previously. Our phone number is 610-376-6988. Our agency has other programs that if you are interested in our agency, we do have more programs, not only the CAP program. But give us a call and we will see what we could do there. Again, an announcement from BCTV. We still need 75 new members by June 30th to support. Let's support the community media needs you. You could go into www.bctv.org, support us, and then be a member. Girls, you want to say something else? Again, este programa que estábamos mencionando, el propósito es ayudar a estos estudiantes en la escuela a crear una manera positiva de ver el futuro y enseñarle a estos estudiantes ¿Cómo bregar con estas presiones de grupo, con la intimidación que está sucediendo afuera en la calle, violencia, gangas, todo lo que nosotros podamos enseñarle a estos niños de tercer, cuarto y quinto grado que están en las escuelas que mencioné previamente, todo lo positivo que se le pueda enseñar? Aquí estamos nosotros, todos somos bilingües, tenemos empleados bilingües que hablan español e inglés. Es un lugar positivo después de la escuela. The girls know it is a positive and safe. We do give the snack and yes. we have the incentive. Good snack, right?
Yes, but it's to make sure.
Good snacks? Okay. This is it. I'll see you next time. Thank you.